if you're not so much into classical music, you will still probably know this piece. And if you're not so much into going to classical music, you will still probably know this concert. In case that you couldn't answer these questions, this is the Ratatouille March by Johann Strauss, played on every single year of the New Year's concert. If you know the concert, or if you know a little bit, you will know that always on the second repetition of the main motif of this piece, all the public always claps along the orchestra. I've been watching this concert for many, many years, and last year I was watching it once again with my family, and I asked myself why the people claps along the beat with the orchestra. Is it because it's written on the score? Is it because the composer said so? And I started my little research. It turns out that on the score, there's nothing anywhere which says that the public should clap. And there's no statement, there's no letter of Johann Strauss that said that people should clap along the beat. So I started asking myself, even more, why people clap with the beat? Why the conductors kind of enable that even more? So I started again my research, and it turns out that Viennese tradition of clapping to the Ratatouille March is actually quite funny. So I'm here to share it to all of you. First of all, to understand the piece and to understand why this piece came to life, we have to get a little bit of history background. We have to go back to the year 1848, when the revolution shook Europe with wave after wave of civil unrest. Some territories that were part of the Austrian Empire, which today are part of Italy, decided to make a push for their own independence, which this led to the Imperial Royal Army, which was led by the Field Marshal Joseph Radetzky von Kladetz, had to go and fight for their territories. On the 24th of July, the Field Marshal Radetzky's troops defeated the army of the Kingdom of Sardinia in the Battle of Custoza, which this led them to regain the territory and make victory. On the same time, Johann Strauss decided to create his Opus 228, a march commissioned to the honor 81-year-old Radetzky and the Imperial Royal Army, while benefiting wounded war veterans at their victory celebration in Vienna. It was very surprising the age of that marshal and that he won. So the piece was premiered on the 31st of August 1848, when the Field Marshal Radetzky arrived in full military dress to greet the throngs of people who had come to celebrate his decisive victory. He was with all the soldiers and everyone supporting him. And it's when the Radetzky March was premiered for the first time ever in the city of Vienna. The piece started to play, everyone started to love it, and the soldiers started to love it, and they started clapping to the beat to show love, to show appreciation, and to show all the much excitement about the piece. And since then, this is a tradition that has been passed down. So basically, nowadays, we clap to the song because the soldiers in 1848 decided to clap to show love to the beast. And it has become some sort of Viennese tradition to clap to the second repetition of the main motif of that piece. So I really hope that you enjoyed this video. I hope you could learn something interesting related to classical music that I think it's quite funny and cute. You can give thumbs up to this video. You can comment here down below what you think about it. Did you know about this already? What do you want to see also in the future on this channel? And I'll see you all of you in the next video. Thank you so much.
Bye.